and Cindy Clawson at the line is your new leader.
On the strength of incredible athletes, Canada has won more medals in speed skating than any other Olympic sport.
It is Clara Hughes of Canada gold!
Its value to Canada's Olympic reputation can't be overstated.
They're going into the final turn.
But the team will compete in Korea without a head coach. Earlier this week, CBC News reported Canada's head coach of the speed skating program, Michael Crowe, has taken a leave of absence and an internal investigation is underway. But the Calgary-based team wouldn't say what it was about. Now we've learned Speed Skating Canada CEO Susan Auk, herself a former competitor, contacted at least one former U.S. athlete last year. Eva Rodansky says Auk asked about allegations Rodansky had made that Crowe had more than one affair with skaters under his direction when he ran the U.S. program.
I believed it had to do with the things I had written about in the past.
Rodansky competed for the U.S. but quit the team ahead of the Olympics in 2006, believing Crowe had favored a rival for an Olympic spot because she alleges he was romantically involved with the other athlete. She believes that gave the other woman a competitive advantage in training.
If you were a woman in speed skating, your experience in speed skating was completely different under Michael Crowe than a man's experience under Michael Crowe. All a man had to do is show up and be talented.
CBC News has not independently verified Rodansky's allegations. Years earlier, Chantal Cermak competed for the U.S., and contacted by CBC News by telephone, she says she had an affair with Crowe while he coached her in the 1990s.
I felt so stuck in this moral turmoil. He is the best coach in the world, in my opinion. He got me from 10th in the United States to first. What was I supposed to do?
She, too, alleges Crowe was involved with more than one athlete he coached. Cermak says she's learned Speed Skating Canada also wants to hear from her. Skate Canada's code of conduct for athletes in place since 1999 is clear. At no time can coaches become intimately or sexually involved with their athletes. It's not clear whether the U.S. program had the same rule. Crowe and some other members of the coaching staff were replaced by the U.S. in 2006 after the team underperformed at the Olympics in Turin. Crowe was hired by Speed Skating Canada the following year, and in 2015 he was promoted to oversee the entire program. Speed Skating Canada won't say if it knew about allegations of Crowe's past involvement with U.S. athletes when he was hired or what's prompted its investigation now. We haven't seen any indication he was involved with skaters here. CBC News has attempted to contact Michael Crowe for his comment, but he hasn't responded to our requests. Diana Swain, CBC News, Toronto.